Nias. Dear Tiago, I am a fan of Dobbs, but still got confused of buying whether 8 or 10 or 12 maximum. Also, which cheap and best brand will you recommend for me, please? I mean cheap and best mirror. Look, the mirrors of the commercial Dobbs nowadays, they are selling all the same. It's all the same stuff. You can buy Skywatcher or GSO, or it's all the same stuff. Choose an aperture and then buy according to the accessories they have. And if they are in stock, of course, and if the shipping prices, buy with that thing in mind. And now, about the aperture, it depends. The 8-inch, it's the most versatile because it's light. It's lighter than a 10-inch and 12-inch. And it has good views. It's already a good... Even the 6-inch, this 6-inch, has good views. But the 8-inch better, the 10-inch better, of course. And the 12-inch, even better. Look, I have a 6-inch, an 8-inch, and a 12-inch. If today I had to choose to have just one telescope to be here at home, I will keep the 12-inch Dobsonian because the aperture gives me better views. There's no... The people can cry and can post and complain and tell those their theories about that, but the truth is the aperture rules. That's the truth. Even with bad seeing, we are watching well Jupiter because it's a 12-inch. If I place the 6-inch with this seeing awful outside, we would not have the views we are having today with Jupiter. These views with bad seeing. Look, the clouds darken again. It's clouds. This is the clouds. I will increase again for us to see. This is awful, awful seeing. Dew outside. Haze, clouds. The only thing, it's the wind. It's no wind. You can see the thing is awful, and it's getting worse now. And the views we can have with a 12-inch, at least we can see some bands here. Let me refocus to see if it can help. Sometimes the focus change. No, it's the same. It's really the thing. Now let me decrease the gain again. It's the clouds. This is the clouds. So if I had to choose the 12-inch, but if I live, for instance, in an apartment where a 12-inch is a cumbersome, I will pick probably an 8-inch. But if I live in Bortle 9, in the middle of New York or Madrid or London, I would rather prefer the 8-inch, thinking in travel with it. Actually, if I was living in the middle of a big city, this would be my choice, the 6-inch. To grab and go, it will be my choice. So it depends. There's not a simple answer to that. If it's to be like me, always in the same place, the 12-inch. Remember, you need tracking, because then you, no matter what, again, no matter what many people say around the internet, and you don't take pictures with a Dobsonian, you will take pictures. They are, people that say that are stuck in the past. The new generations, we and the new generations want a picture. They will like visual, because visual is visual. Nothing can replace visual, and nothing can replace a Dobsonian for visual observations. But with a Dobsonian, you can have all of that, and also you can take pictures like we are doing and watch everything in the sky, everything, small things, small deep sky objects, and a bit larger. Only if you prefer too large objects, you will prefer a refracted, but then you can't go to objects like we captured, like Pluto and things like that. No way. Unless, and they are more expensive. So remember to buy with a go-to or you have to buy an equatorial platform later. It's your choice. It depends on what you want. If you only want really visual, I believe that there's some people that want, but later I see the people that I just want visual. Then after some months they are asking, what can I do to take some pictures? People don't know what they want. And if they are guided not by what they see here with us, you can see what we do, and they are guided by corporations that want to sell stuff, you will not buy a Dobsonian to take pictures, of course. They want to sell stuff, and that's, I understand that. They have a company to run. I really understand that. So that depends. The 18-inch is usually a fair choice. And if it's go-to, you have a telescope for life.